Oh my god, Leo, your math teacher seeks revenge. Which teacher? He's Daffensmirtz. Daffens. What a complicated name. I bet the show where he comes from has a humor limited to funny words like platypus.
Yeah, more or less. But Duff is different. He's an evil scientist who wants to take over the world.
Of course.
His inventions may look pathetic, but they have many opportunities to surprise us with their weird side effects.
What type of side effects?
Have you ever pictured yourself inside of a green bubble or with a dress?
Yes, sometimes, but I'm sure he can't get over my magic. It's 1,000 times weirder. Leo? 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 Leo?
Ready? 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 Ready?
If you are being ironic, Sheldon is not going to get it. He's a genius, but small details get out of his understanding.
Another scientist? At least, this one doesn't make strange things. He just uses geeky weapons like disguises, lamps, and paintballs.
Don't forget about his final smash. Stone, paper, scissors, lizard, Spock.
How do you play that?
Easy. Paper, smash, scissors.
No, ready, don't tell me. I can deduce it.
Finally, someone who isn't a scientist.
Well, Yzma originally was a sorceress who wanted to snuff out the light, like Mr. Burns. Then, she was changed to a potion creator.
Pociones.
Magicas. I think you will need a doctorate to continue in Lol Nova.
It doesn't matter. All of Yzma's tricks are unrelated to magic.
She uses traps and her henchman Kronk for absolutely everything.
Does she also have a dumb and buff sidekick? Copycat.
Yzma wants to become the Empress of the Incas, so she fights with dirty cheats,
like animal transforming potions. But why should I care? I am a head god wizard!
Look, Reddy! A character who's not a scientist!
She still uses magic weapons like me. I don't like her.
Zelda is the princess from Hyrule Kingdom, and its defender when Link is absent.
Didn't Zelda already appear in Melee, Brawl, 3DS, Wii U and Ultimate?
Those are the official Zeldas from Nintendo consoles. This one is the version from Philips CDI.
I remember that thing. It has really funny animations.
CDI Zelda is a skillful fighter full of surprises. If we don't pay attention, we could get chained and trapped in Gamelion.
I thought those games were chidos la neta, about dominating minions and exploring a magic world. Look, Leo, another Nintendo character. Who will be next? Yosuke Irion?
Let's just say that Lol Nova does what Nintendo done. Can you believe this character is appearing in Lol before actual Smash?
In fact, Captain Namco is the most representative character from Nintendo crossovers.
After Sakurai himself.
He's like Sora for Disney, or Michael Jordan for Warner, who are also in other Lols.
That's not all. He's a hero who takes advantage of gaming knowledge instead of focusing on pop culture references.
His fanatism is properly used through NES accessories and video game assistants like Kid Icarus, Simon Bolivar, and Astro Boy.
Don't talk about new characters or they will be requested in the next empty slot.
Then demand a higher production value. I can barely move. Holy Hippolyte. This is from the best Hercules movie ever.
That's debatable. How many adaptations could be?
They fall into obscurity. It's what happens when you are China's favorite Roman god.
And Hollywood's two horrible movies about him were released in 2014.
The legend says there's no worse version than Dingo Pictures.
Just look at the drawing. Is it from a collaboration between John DiMico and David Chanatos?
Don't worry, Asylum could surely do it worse. I wonder what happens in Tale of Donkey Kong et Abel el Real de A.
Are you actually describing the character?
Which character? That one?
Yes. His name is Tungai Bruce.
I'm not good at French, but is he really the cartoon painter of an individual that will spend his cell-shaped hair?
Like a good pirate, he carries a lot of treasures. He comes from a graphic adventure series made by LucasArts,
the same studio that make Star Trek and Todd the Lost Explorer.
Sometimes I wonder if you intentionally mistake the names or you are that stupid.
So what? Are you going to fire me?
Oh!
Look, Leo, it's Spider-Man's girlfriend from the nursery rhymes.
Don't mess with Elsa, she could easily freeze us. We are doomed if she gets to her heart. She can properly control her ice powers.
Who would want to build a snowman with her? An invisible meter of magic will be useful to deal with her magic.
Just be careful with her icy slabs and walls,
or use fire. The actress from Snakes on a Plane ready let herself go.
Wasn't that Adelda Sim?
Who's that gentleman?
Timmy Stubb.
Doesn't he have a name?
Yes, but not saying it is a running gag.
Timmy Pickle's daddy surely does some weird stuff.
That's nothing. All his attacks come from fairy magic.
Then, the easy way of defeating him would be stating we don't believe in fairies.
No, I think that happens with wizards.
Better forget about that. Magic against magic sounds like a fair match.
Remember, he can clone up to 3 times. Dr. Clone, Black Clone, and Clone with Vagina.
Tomasito Pepinillos is a true gangster. Look, it's Dipper Jimenez.
I will say your confusion doesn't make any sense, but Gravity Falls theories can get so crazy that who knows.
Didn't he have an inseparable sister?
Yes, but she was Pat in another role.
Or they just want us to buy her as DLC.
No, she will hopefully be free if we have LOL Nova for both 3DS and Wii U.
And the bootleg version with Michael Jordan.
Surprisingly, Dipper Pines is really powerful for a kid. He has a good amount of paranormal items like a size changing flashlight, time traveling tape, dream bubbles, and a regular camera.
Haha, mirlopinos.
If he gets a smash ball, we'll use a book to summon monsters.
Man, he has more magics than me, and I am a fellow wizard! Look, it's Iker Pines.
Is that your crazy Gravity Falls theory? Because it would make more sense than Levan.
Doesn't he have the same eyes from another LOL's character?
Exactly, that's Phil Cipher possessing Dipper Pines.
I can't believe Gravity Falls has fusions in LOL before Steven Universe.
We would need to wait for the next empty slot in order to suggest them.
I will vote for Charles Barkley.
Regarding Dipper, it's not surprising he combines Bill's powers and Dipper's brains. He doesn't need a flashlight to change sizes, because he has 2 magic eyes.
His artifacts include a measuring tape for time travel, a sphere made of nightmares, and a camera with magic properties. Haha, solo rondo.
If he gets a smash ball, he will call one of his friends, the Hench Maniacs,
from whom we know nothing even after buying Journal 3. I should have spent my money on video editing software to make my own LOL.
Finally, Spider-Man returned to Marvel Studios. Some rat boys want him in Smash, but LOL fits way better, especially this incarnation from the 60s, when superheroes couldn't be taken seriously.
This version is the second funniest next to the 70s Japanese one.
Don't forget the Italian.
But this isn't the pure 60s incarnation because Joss Whedon reprises his voice from Spectacular Spider-Man to give life to those wall-crawling memes.
Also, his powers are used in such bizarre ways comparable to Lemon Emon. He's very unpredictable.
That's what even a spider can? Since when are spiders able to create flying mustaches or Toon Donkey Kong barrels?
Internet is so weird. Wizard Heck Dogs, Octopus Cats, Bad Shaped Wigs. I bet you couldn't film those in 60s television.
Amen.
That's our analysis. Watch the first year anniversary special of Retropokon for more depth.
Johnny's a joke, a bad one, and I don't like him at all.
His hair looks like a bat. Look, Leo, it's Mecha Boy.
No, Reddy, it's another famous monochromatic figure from the most random site of YouTube.
My counterpart from Dick Figures? I haven't followed that show since I started to produce my own biopic.
Yeah, your great story nobody knows about.
I bet it's complex and totally not full of random humor. My humor isn't random. I don't even try to be humorous.
What's your deal then?
It's a confusing perception of reality for being infinite versions of myself in uncountable dimensions at the same time. Get it already, Leo.
I get it. The classic Lemon Emon logic. Like if Lemon Emon invented randomness. The base of life and physics from other worlds could be nonsense in ours.
Exactly. I assure you this character is the most regular guy from the Tomskaverse.
He doesn't even have a name. He's just the ASDF movie guy.
His simplicity goes farther. ASDF are the first letter from the second line on your keyboard.
I didn't notice. What does the acronym mean?
A simple dick figure.
So this is the scientist's arch enemy.
Sheldon Cooper?
No, the other one.
Yzma?
The other one.
Bizarro John?
I'm taking about Heinz Doofenshmirtz.
Dang it, you should have just said your maths teacher and we would have ended earlier.
Perry is an adorable platypus, but also a skillful secret agent with plenty of gadgets.
Platypus sounds funny.
Don't be so confident. Looking fishy is part of his strategy. Once you guard down, he will catch you with his grappling hook or make you fly with a jetpack.
Or the sea devil. It's been a while since I last said that. We had to keep the meme really banned.
Oh no, it's a protagonist from an anime about cards.
Homestuck is not about cards, nor an anime. Looks like you don't know much about Homestuck.
You mean Homestuck?
Yeah, that one.
This girl seems to have a sort of interdimensional origin. She has item cards and a magic dog with magic powers.
And let's not forget the enchanted armor.
Neither the robot, which she can control during her sleep.
I come to the conclusion she's the living nexus between Marvel, Capcom, and Oscar's nightmares.
Her final smash even looks like a Gaudry ascension. She's going full Kikiyama.
Shh! Don't spoil Darkstack, Reddy!
I would never spoil Dark Pokon winning a ball. Look, Waleo, we are plot twists from the John Show.
Expecting the regular Leon Reddy? Too bad! Wedding time!
And the best of all Waluigi's hates LOL.
All the LOL food, trust, he will spit it.
LOL in the family will be funny again, with a Jafar disguise.
This would have been Wafar's woofset. Waleo hates this.
The only gratifying thing is surfing and turning everything we touch into mini-me's.
Learning hard with Waluigi is gooder, if you let me finish in the pictures.
Wahaha, wahaha.
Is it too late for Arambe jokes?
But it's never too late for jokes about expanding donks.
Anyways, this dirty and ugly monkey comes from the same anime as Blaster Kong.
The show that should have told Robert Zemeckis that motion capture animation is spooky.
Unless it has a character made of balls called Mocap.
Being King Kong's biggest fan, this similarly named ape comes from an island full of magic artifacts,
like a crystal coconut, which can be launched direct to DVD.
Coconut cream pies while imitating Danny Rovira,
driving Carrero Blanco's car.
Using a barrel like his Smash counterpart back in Donkey Kong Circus, which is not canon for Mario being a communist.
And crash planes into the stage if none of that works.
To be a singing ape with a tie, he is very ill-tempered.
Oh my jinka dinka dong! Is it too late for Funky Kong jokes?
But it's never too late for making fun of Danny Rovira.
Anyways, this atomic neonuclear ape comes from the same anime as Dunkey Rule.
The show where Steven Spielberg discovered that motion capture animation was perfect for Tintin.
Unless it has a character made of vectors called Quochai Ren.
Being Frankenstein's biggest fan, this ape with a hairy band name is an invention of Cranky Kong.
Like his coconut head, which can be thrown and toast bread.
Being bananas for bananas while imitating Best Hira.
Jumping with the Flying Grayson's trampoline.
Using a barrel like Diddy Kong did with himself in Donkey Kong Country Returns, which is not canon for Super Mario Who.
And 5 paints in the back if that doesn't work.
To be a one-off robot ape, it really has some moves.
But my favorite musical about apes is still Dr. Sayus. Look, Leo, a random wizard. How original.
You mean a character that actually uses her powers instead of just commenting?
They are not regular powers, but magical powers. And religious.
Whatever. Estrella Mariposa comes from the magical kingdom of Starlingrad.
She can open portals with the help of Rosario Tijeras, which are not used in her moveset, just like Voldemort's sword.
Although her magic is so varied and complex, she needs no more weapons beyond that.
All her spells are cool and cute stuff ripped from Lady Yel.
But if she runs out of LGTB magic, she can ask the Cloud from Final Fantasy for help to defend herself,
or she will lose the rainbow bending powers, using her bands to propel herself.
Ew! Luckily, she has a charger for that. It allows her shooting a Mega Buster.
Her final smash turns her into an actual butterfly.
Yes! This moveset has gotten a little weird.
This will get a little wild.
Because Star ain't from around here.
Please remove the autotune. Hi, I'm Reddy the Wizard straight from my magic fire.
Hello, my name is Cold Leo.
Today, we present the new LOL Nova Fighter, Vince Offer.
That's left, Rojito. Vince is a fighter that promotes his products with a set of moves.
Behold the Slap Chop. With it, you can shred food and your opponents with ease.
For present, gratis for cheese. It's well and comfortable.
But wait, there's more. For just $9.99, your Vince Offer DLC will come with the sticky to clean while you clean walls.
Fresh, straight from gel. It includes some wow.
It can increase 20 times its size. You can absorb the 20% of La Mancha. You will become the biggest genocide of Spain.
With Vince Offer, you are gonna have a mal tiempo.
Call now, and we will erase the stage with a giant spray.
Vince is invincible.
You can pay by credit card or with cash in the Euronian card. Tell me, do you believe? You will! Nosebleed! After years of being suggested, Batman has finally joined LOL. Not Marvel vs. Capcom, Injustice or Return of Shinobi. LOL is the first game actually pitting Spider-Man against Batman. Unless we count the endless Smash mods with Paper Moves remakes. There's 60 years of wait, paid off with the onomatopeyas. He is Adam West, the original TV Batman, who predates 60s Crazy Memes by years, accompanied by Bart Ward. Bart? Who the sea devil is called Bart? Blimey Reddy, don't you know about the classic funny Batman? The founder of PlatanoBoligrafo.com? Who almost fought Godzilla after drawing against Toon Donkey Kong's hero? Nah. Please, introduce him to the audience why I bad deduct it with a Batman gambit. I thought Batman was a Tarkis city until now. 60s Batman is the original Inspector Gadget and has more inventions than Q and Doofenshmirtz together. Is he weak against magic? No. That's his anti-friend Superman. This one is vulnerable to his own stupidity misusing the bad gadgets. Luckily, Robin Williams helps him. Wholly unexpected Fire Emblem cameo. He has lasers, bombs straight off the Looney Tunes, ropes that summon cameos like John DiMico's chair, and a shark repellent spray that also materializes sharks. It can create stuff from thin air that later explodes? That spray is made from my portals, but with sharks! Do you know what we are? We are Samuel L. motherfucking Jackson's fanboys. And we like hentai too. Do not get up. It seems like Samuel and I have found you having breakfast. Which is your LOL food? Wimpy style noodles. Are those noodles yours? Can I try them?
Yes, have some.
They sure are tasty. Have you tried the Wimpy style noodles, Samuel?
Hey, sorry if things have gone upside down with me and Mr.
Oh, I'm sorry. Maybe I broke your concentration. It wasn't my intention. Tell me, how is Samuel L. Jackson like?
What?
How is his moveset like?
What?
I don't know any attack called what. Is what his neutral B?
What?
Do you speak my language? Describe Samuel L. Jackson to me. How is he?
What?
Say what again? Say what again? I dare you. I double dare you, motherfucker.
Alright. He enters via helicopter transformation.
Continue.
His neutral B is interrogating, like you are doing right now, but with a gun.
Does he look like a bitch?
What?
I said, does he look like a bitch?
No, but he has a bomb that can be balanced with water jacks, snakes on a plane and sharks on submarines.
What?
What do you mean with what? Don't you realize the other character has the shark repellent?
I don't know. I thought what was a magic word, but the magic word is actually a counter with a twist.
Oh, those magic words. So mean. No, Reddy. We already did that one. Wash Rival is not a video game tune, but the illustrator from the Awkward Zombie webcomic.
A webcomic about zombies feeling awkward? Is that some kind of metaphor of two sarcastic main characters talking about games on their couch?
More or less, Katie Tidridge has an avatar that interacts with the video game characters, like Captain N,
but without teammates. Although she can control others with that megaphone, like La Morgan from The Suicer.
Or force us to marry Target, not that I mind.
Better leave her to me. She's a wizard too. You should keep War Turtle instead, who will evolve into Blastoise if you train it. But my favorite will always be Eve.
Blastoise! Blastoise! Oh my god!
If she disappears, it's because she's inside a box or has flown away like in the movie called The 100-Year-Old Man Who Climbs Out of the Window and Disappears.
And most importantly, avoiding the wild entity from the final smash.
That mysterious Minter Entei is a danger. I hope this one isn't constantly ranting about Tio Familia. So this is the villain from Mathiste Against the Cocodrilling King.
Does that movie exist?
No. But doesn't it sound real now?
He's the cruel king from the Donkey Kong et Avere Real de a cartoon. He's a king, a pirate, a scientist, a boxer, a miner.
He's a moonlighter.
Instead of being a lazy king like the one from Spain, he actually plays a part when he steals bananas from the Kongs.
For that, he uses an arsenal of weapons that start with the letter K. Clamp Blaster, Clamp Cannon, the KCCBM.
King DDD doesn't sound as stupid now, does he?
It's like if he had his own sponsor, whose mandatory name would be Agent Key.
He has too many things at his disposal.
Even he has time to drink Dicky and Flatty TM banana soda and increase his stats.
But his most dangerous tool is the orange satellite. If it traps someone, it will end anywhere and very hard.
It's like the Cloverfield Paradox, giant crocodile inclusive. Explain, Leo. I am kind of lost in the O-Stan lore.
It's actually easier than it sounds. The Siha girls are Moe anthropomorphizations of the Sega consoles.
Moe. Their names are Bubblegum Susie, Dark Miku, and Maiden Robin 123.
No, they are Dreamcast, Sega Saturn, and Mega Drive. They have a great friendship, even though they take turns and sometimes go solo.
They are seemingly trying to graduate in the high school from Ready Player John.
And if they find a Smash Ball, they will set in their adorable humanized forms aside to fire in sports.
Unless the principal arrives to expose us to the Aurora Borealis. Dreamcaster has something for big ice creams, like me, except she uses them as swords.
She has a rather bizarre arsenal, such a controller to control herself and a changing boot that works like all changing boots in anime.
Good thing that despite tight veins named Dreamcast, she doesn't have poor mouth animations. Saturnine Sega is exactly what you expect from a Dark Miku. Her weapon is a gun that instead of being edgy can get herself naked.
She also has some sticks that allow her to use avatar-esque powers from Shyamalan, not Cameron.
And some rapey blows that...
Ready! No swearing in LOL Nova!
But that's the name of the yellow corpse from Final Fantasy Star vs. The Forces Awakens.
What a relief! I didn't want your commentaries to be as outdated as the Sega Saturn itself. Or as our original commentary from John DiMico, which didn't exactly tease Infernals and Theriums.
Mega Driving is a summoner of 16-bit creatures from Sega games, a bit like her rival Captain N, without exactly being the same mechanic. Well played.
She compensates her subpar athletic abilities with encyclopedic knowledge about Sega items and rocket rollerblades.
I love her crossover with Fistroman, historia de una gran corrida.
Well, ready, I made it, despite your misdirections.
Oh, Leonardo Theodore Goth, if I correctly remember. I hope you're prepared for an unforgettable Lowleon. Oh my god, Videopath has crashed. But what if I were to take a joke moveset and disguise it as a real character? Delightfully hell is ready.
Ready?
Leo, I was just imitating Skinner's entrance. The motorbike, care to join me?
Why are rats in the moveset ready?
No, that isn't a rat, it's Nibbles. Nibbles from the neutral V Skinner's having. Great phoning. And I hope you're ready for an ingenious rocket vacuum.
I thought this side B was Albany.
No. I said rocket vacuum. That's what I call the side B.
You call the Super Nintendo Chalmers Statler?
Yes, it's a regional dialect.
What region?
Upstate Cantabria.
Really? Well, I'm from Candalucía and I have never heard anyone use the word Stapler.
Oh, not in Candalucía, no. It's an expression from Universe 096B.
I see. You know, this up B isn't quite similar to the Aurora Borealis.
No, the up B is an old family trick.
And it's called I'm Big Bat Skinner.
Yes.
So you call it Big Bat Skinner despite the fact it's a balloon with that name and not an actual Big Bat Skinner.
Yeah, you know, excuse me for a second.
Of course.
Yeah. Well, that was a wonderful moveset. Both reviews will have a yell. I'm poop.
Yes, I should be. Good lord, what's happening here?
The final smash.
The final smash. Without a smash ball. In the middle of a review. During a no items per only final destination match.
Yes.
May I see it?
No.
Ready, the stitch is on fire.
No, Leo. It's just a Vietnam flashback.
Well, Skinner is an odd fellow. But I must say, his team's a good lol food.
Who is that figura?
Crack Figure, another guy who was normal in his crazy world, but out of context, a complete killing machine.
I think it is a physical education teacher. On crack!
It wants to trump us with balls. If they are thrown in slow-mo, we are dead. And if they are tossed out of the stage, they will fall on our heads.
That pogo is the Undertaker's dream. We must be careful, or it will scrooge McFuck or asses.
And let's not forget the sponsors. The new Fanta Wanta will heal the percentage as long as there are no more items in possession.
Holy Seraphs never taste alcohol.
If it gets a smash ball, we will have to avoid tall grass like in those Porkerion games, or else hamburgers will rain.
It's like that Sony animation movie, Burgernado.
Joel from Vine's House, the future of Let's Players.
Oh, the world is changing.
Joel has gained thousands of followers over the years,
by streaming wet dreams and programs. It seems like he wrote them as human seals. Poor Luis Fonsi.
His arsenal is complex. He throws aggressive pizzas that you better not eat or they will explode from your inside.
He also has his own Cuphead alternative universe. It's still a glitchy beta though.
And lastly, dragons you must not get close to or you will get stunned or conquered.
His last resource is bombing Norway. I guess he's not a fan of such dishes like Rackfish, Raspeboller or Smalahov. David Smalahov is so tasty.
What is Irene Villa doing in LOL?
Don't start with your Irene Villa jokes, Reddy.
No, I'm talking about that Melina clone.
They are called Echo Fighters now. Besides, haven't you watched the Frollo show? He's like the opposite of a Hikinomori. He goes out, drinks, and smokes weed even more than us.
She looks quite healthy. Is it because of her skating? Or did she do some kind of contract?
That could explain her transformation into a witch. However, her powers actually come from an alternative world through the Looking Glass,
where she can become a queen and lose her legs.
Her main attack is those colorful cannonballs, with confusing effects and patterns.
And the whale will eat us in her final smash. That way we will bleed out and live happily ever after.
Here's a riddle. What 3D platformer with a hat motif revived the collectathon genre?
Super Mario Odyssey?
Almost.
For fun?
I'm talking about A Hat in Time, and its mustache-less playable character.
Evil mustaches should be normalized anyways, but this kid is cute as hell.
In fact, she uses her hats like Monado Arts. Each one gives her a skill and a special move.
She has the Beating Hat, allowing her to throw peace potions.
The Spring Hat, which turns her into Paperboy.
The Cold Hat, for the resistance and resistance against the flu.
The Resident's Mask, kind of like a hat, but gives off a superiority aura.
And the Sorting Hat, which tells you which kind of wizard you are.
You just made that one up.
What sounds made up is her final smash, where she plays Katamari 20XX and defeats everyone with a simple Fraggle Fraggle. Weird. That interdimensional clone is not obeying me.
Well, that mustn't be one of your tricks. We are in a fighting game after all, so we should trust nobody, not even ourselves.
How could we defeat ourselves? That sounds paradoxical.
Maybe if we analyze our attacks, we could find a way, but I can only assist you. So I don't mind if you turn me into different things.
Even I can trust my own magic for how random it is. If I wanted to invoke specific elements, I would really need to concentrate.
That's why I bring the couch, to sit while you open portals to parallel universes.
Instead of having actual sources, I could improvise my own attacks based on the fighter reviews.
Such a Metallian gag.
And if I get zero resources, I could de-evolve into my original inspiration, the Wizard Sonic with the paint emeralds.
For a joke that started in bath animations, I think you went too far.
And this is only the beginning.